Are you committing in this interview that you are not going to let any of these banks fail? That no matter what their balance sheet actually looks like, they are not going to fail?
They're not going to fail.
Is that tax money that the Fed is spending?
It's not tax money. The banks have accounts with the Fed much the same way that you have an account in a commercial bank. So to lend to a bank, we simply use the computer to mark up the size of the account that they have with the Fed. So it's much more akin, although not exactly the same, but it's much more akin to printing money than it is to borrowing.
You've been printing money.
Well, effectively, and we need to do that because our economy is very weak and inflation is very low. When the economy begins to recover, that'll be the time that we need to unwind those programs, raise interest rates, reduce the money supply, and make sure that we have a recovery that does not involve inflation.
He's not kidding about printing money. The Fed issues U.S. currency. That's why it says Federal Reserve Note on all the bills in your wallet. This is the Bureau of Engraving and Printing, just a few blocks from Bernanke's office. The Fed's mandate from Congress is to put enough money in the system for maximum employment, but not so much that it sets off inflation. The Fed actually pays for itself and returns billions in profits to the Treasury. This past Sunday, the Fed dropped interest rates nearly to zero. Then, every day last week, it announced emergency lending programs. It pledged to spend at least $700 billion supporting mortgages, banks, money market mutual funds, corporate bonds, and lending to central banks of other countries, because the dollar is the currency of world trade.
We are being very aggressive, and I think our chairman, Jay Powell, has learned from the experience of 2008. We're moving much faster than we moved in 2008. We're being more aggressive. Is there more we can do? Yes. Is there more we may end up doing? Yes. But I think we're being very aggressive, and I think that's the right thing.
Can you characterize everything that the Fed has done this past week as essentially flooding the system with money?
Yes, exactly.
And there's no end to your ability to do that?
There is no end to our ability to do that.
Another economic hangover after the pandemic is a sharp increase in the national debt. 30 years from now, it is projected to be $144 trillion, or $1 million per household.
But is the national debt a danger to the economy, in your view?
In the long run, the U.S. is on an unsustainable fiscal path. The U.S. federal government's on an unsustainable fiscal path. And that just means that the debt is growing faster than the economy.
I have the sense this worries you very much.
Over the long run, of course it does. You know, we're borrowing from future generations. It's time for us to get back to putting a priority on fiscal sustainability. And sooner is better than later.